Welcome to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading Biography of Queen Barenziah, Volume 3, which I found right here on this table in Dereni Tower. This is a good landmark for where I found it. Biography of Queen Barenziah, Volume 3. Barenziah was welcomed kindly by the Emperor Tiber Septim and his family, who treated her like a daughter during her stay in the newly built Imperial City. After several happy months there learning her duties as a regent under the Empire, Symmachus escorted her to Mournhold, where she took up her duties as queen of her people, under his wise guidance. Gradually they came to love one another and were married and crowned in a splendid ceremony at which the Emperor himself officiated. After several hundred years of marriage, a son, Helseth, was born to the royal couple, amid rejoicing and prayers to the goddess who had at last blessed their marriage. Although it was not known at the time, it was surely before this blessed event that the Staff of Chaos was stolen from its hiding place deep in the Mournhold mines by a clever bard known only as Nightingale. 8 years after Helseth's birth, Barenziah bore a daughter, Morgia, named for Symmachus's mother, and the royal couple's joy was complete. Alas, shortly after that, relations with the Empire mysteriously deteriorated, leading to much civil unrest in Mournhold. After fruitless inquiries and attempts at reconciliation, in desperation, Barenziah took her young children and traveled to Imperial City herself to seek the Emperor's ear. Symmachus remained in Mournhold. During her audience with the Emperor, Barenziah, through her magical arts, came to realize, to her horror and dismay, that the so-called Emperor was an impostor, none other than the bard Nightingale who had stolen the Staff of Chaos. Exercising great self-control, she concealed this realization from him. That evening, news came that Symmachus had been killed in battle and that Mournhold had been taken by the rebels. Barenziah knew not where to seek help when a knock sounded at her door. It was Edwire, King of Wayrest, and an old friend of Uriel Septim and Symmachus. He comforted her, pledged his friendship, and confirmed her suspicions that the Emperor was indeed an impostor, and none other than Jaegar Tharn, the Imperial Battle Mage. Tharn had supposedly retired from public work and put his assistant, Rhea Silmain, in his stead. As it seemed, Tharn had never left the Imperial City. Rhea was indeed dead, but her ghost had appeared in Edwire's dreams and revealed that the true Emperor had been kidnapped by Tharn and imprisoned in an alternate plane. Tharn had then used the Staff of Chaos to kill her when she attempted to warn the Council of his nefarious plot. Together, Edwire and Barenziah plotted to gain the impostor's confidence and unmask him with the help of another friend of Rhea's, who was currently in prison but to whose dreams she had access, and who possessed great, albeit untapped, potential. Barenziah charmed and befriended the fake Emperor. By reading his secret diary, she learned that he had broken the staff into 8 pieces and hidden them. She managed to obtain a copy of the key to Rhea's friend's cell and bribed a guard to leave it within the cell, as if by accident. Their champion, whose name was unknown even to Barenziah in Edwire, made his escape through a shift gate Rhea had opened in a dark, rat-infested corner of the prison where the cowardly goblin guards feared to venture. It took Barenziah several months to learn the hiding places of all 8 staff pieces through snatches of overheard conversation and rare glimpses of the diary. Once she had the vital information, she and Edwire fled to Wayrest, where they managed to stave off the sporadic efforts of Tharn's henchmen to obtain revenge. Tharn, whatever else might be said of him, was no one's fool, save perhaps Barenziah's, and he concentrated most of his efforts in tracking down and destroying the great champion. As all now know, the brave, tireless, and forever nameless champion was successful in reuniting the Staff of Chaos. With it, he destroyed Tharn and rescued the true Emperor, Uriel Septim VII. Following the restoration, a grand state memorial service was held for Symmachus in the imperial city, befitting the man who had served the Septim family so long and so well. Barenziah and good King Edwire had come to care deeply for one another, and had married in the year after their flight from Imperial City. Her children remained with her, and a regent was appointed to rule Mournhold in her absence. She planned to return after Edwire's death. He was elderly when they were wed, so she knew that event, alas, could not be far off as the elves reckoned time. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall, Biography of Queen Barenziah, Volume 3.